Hello and welcome back to our series. We have installed code block for our series and print hello world in the last video. This is the second video. We will talk about data types. There are three types of data types. They are basic, derived and user defined. Basic or fundamental. They are categorized further into three and we can convert into more. The basic are int, char and float. We can take double, long int, long and more data types. And derived, we will study about array and pointer. And in user defined data type, we will learn about structure, union and enum. This is enumerated. Integer will get, we will talk this later. And let's talk about these three types. Integer will take only the integer number 1, so suppose 1, 2, 3, 2, 9 or combination up to 9, means 0 to 9. And their combination 12, 13, 100, 1000, maybe something. This is A to Z. This is 0.0 to infinity. Infinity point 0 or infinity, something we can say. Here we can take only character value. If we want to take a string from character, we have to utilize an array, that is derived data types. This is float data type, that is with decimal point here. Let's go with our programming of inputting data. First of all, we have to define data with variables. Suppose I want to take integer value from user, let's say A, then I want to print that value, this value. This is printf. We use printf in C. Let's forward it. First of all, we will give message on the board as enter a number. Let's scanf. We will use percentage d for the integer type. Let's say it is, we will give reference with, sorry for this, we will give references, and this is a pointer, it will give references to that variable with the memory. And we will print here, I will print percentage d, means I want to print integer, that is A. We have assigned the value here and we are getting value here, printing here. Let's build and run. Yes, I want to enter 6, as it have given me 6. Let's say here we are not using this logical and, sorry, this is bitwise end. Let's save it and debug, build and run it. Let's try. I am entering 4. It is not giving 4 because, yes, it has crashed that compiler. means it has not given, it has not get any reference. A have not get a reference means memory location has not been allotted for this value. So the value of A is searched in memory, but it has not get actually. So we have to use AND here. Let's get character here. We'll enter character, and this should be char. Yes, we have get. This should be here. We have to change it. This is in your hand. Again, build and run. We can insert only one character here, not more than here. It will give only one character. That is first character has been given here. Let's print float here. This should be float. Enter float. I have used percentage D for integer, C for character, and percentage F for float. We have to remember this. They are very important for our program. Run it. Yes, I want to enter 12.2. Yes, I have get it 246. It will print with 6 integer value, means it will contain 6 integer value. Sorry, there may be disturbance, dogs are barking outside. Let's we have get it. Let's in next video we will talk about condition, that is decision making, how decision making will be done. That is when I want to make you some knowledge about decision making. Suppose there are two marbles A and B. There are two divisions. If you choose A marble, maybe this is blue, and if you choose B marble, that may be red. That may be, if you choose A marble, then it will be blue, else it will be red. Means there are two ways. This is home and school. Here is playground, in between home and school. You are returning home from your school, but at the way you have think that you want to play football, then you will go to playground. The otherwise it you will go to your home. This is the condition or decision making. We will talk about this programmatically in next video. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe.